I'm joined now by Marc Ginsberg. He's a senior advisor at the Counter Extremism Project and a former U.S. ambassador to Mexico. Thank you for joining us. First, I want to establish the credibility and the significance of this worldwide assessment report.
It comes out virtually every year. For those of us who are devotees of the intelligence community in Washington, it's a must read. And it's interesting, from the Obama administration evolving to the Trump administration, we can see more and more how both Russia and China are singled out, particularly at the top of the headings, as the most important regional threats, but cybersecurity issues is at the top of what is called the transnational threat.
So it's a big deal, and it's one thing to disagree or have a differing view, but we have the U.S. president essentially attacking the head of all these intelligence agencies. Where's the disconnect here?
I think, to be perfectly frank, the president obviously does not listen or care to read the daily intelligence briefings that the very people who he selected, who sat before that congressional committee, testified on just yesterday. It's quite evident that despite the fact that he claims that ISIS has been defeated, that his CIA director thinks otherwise, along with perhaps almost anybody else who's involved in the Syria conflict. It's quite clear also that despite the fact that he claims that North Korea no longer poses a nuclear threat and that its WMD program is in the process of being dismantled, that is not shared by his Director of National Intelligence, Dan Coats. I think the only way to read this is that he sees the world the way he wants to see it, and then there's the rest of us, along with his intelligence community, who see it completely differently.
Is that dangerous, given that he is expecting to meet DPRK leader Kim Jong-un in likely a matter of weeks? And then he had these comments on Iran and that his bosses were naive on Iran.
Here is the president declaring, since he ever ran for office, that the Iran nuclear deal was the worst deal, a major catastrophe. And yet, once again, we have his intelligence community claiming that Iran is continuing to abide by the nuclear deal itself, even though it's violating the spirit of the deal by continuing to test ballistic missiles, as well as to engage in regional expansion, imperialism, and terrorism, and remains probably the foremost state sponsor of terror.
What about, the crisis at the U.S.-Mexico border that he also mentioned? And I guess more importantly, what is happening behind the scenes with these intelligence agencies? You know, you can have the president say one thing, but there's real work being done right now.
Particularly on Mexico? Well, there's no doubt that, first of all, the key congressional conference committee that was formed today to try to come up with a solution before the expiration of this deadline coming up, whereby the president has threatened to shut down the government again, has gotten a series of assessments over whether or not, number one, there are terrorists making their way across the border. The answer is no. The director of Homeland Security, who was not testifying yesterday, declared that there is no known terrorist threat. Number two, his intelligence community is telling him that the threat that the president keeps talking about, the invasion of caravans, is just a figment of his imagination. What is going to happen over the next few days, I understand, is that this conference committee is going to bring in the national leading experts on the border situation in Mexico in order to come up with verifiable solutions to what essentially is a problem that almost both Democrats and Republicans believe exists, and that is a porous border whereby thousands and thousands of people are still able to illegally cross and declare asylum.
Marc Ginsberg, great insight. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.